Jesus Christ, to the ministers of the gospel, to the diggers that are assembled, to the congregation, we say good afternoon and may God bless you. For truly God is good and his mercy endures to all generations. I want to thank God for the scroll which reads obedience, love, reverence, and respect. First to God, then to leadership, then to one another. Truly, it has been a blessing to be in this house this day. Amen. Amen. Hear the songs of Zion. Scriptures that are being read, to the testimonies that have gone up in the name of the Lord. It is truly a God-given day that only God could give. Isn't that wonderful? Thank God for the sparks from the anvil on page 3 of the program today. First one says, if you have a religion that don't make you happy, junk it. Amen. These are the words from the elder. You got a religion that don't make you happy. Junk it. Why fool with something that not bringing you any joy or peace? It's one thing I asked Elder Ronald about. They sing like this all the time. At home? He said, yes, they do. I went there one Friday night. I run a little late, and I got in there. And I pulled in the parking lot. It was beaming all outside the windows, and the windows were shut. They were enjoying themselves. So they have a religion, that's true. You can tell, church. Amen. The second one says, you can't do wrong or right under a wrong system. You look at the country today and how disarray it is. Because it's hard to do right under a wrong system. And that's why God sent Christ into the world, to correct the error of man's way, that we might live under a righteous system and then be productive. Amen. The third one says, you cannot go without a leader. And you will not go right without the right leader. We thank God for the man and woman of God in the life of Solomon, Shaw, and his companion who preached and taught the gospel. Elder Raymond C. Wills caught a hold of that, took it to the county. Elder Ronald Hawkins picked it up. When we're out there in West Virginia, found that brother. You heard his testimony. Got him out of the crack house. And that's a bold preacher to go up in the crack house. But he saw fish in it. And today, he's thankful. Amen. You cannot go without a leader. When Elder Hawkins went down, God had a ram in the bush. You know what? Already prepared. Abraham getting ready to slay the son. Say, Abraham, ram in the bush. And Elder Quentin Jones have fulfilled the mission. When I learned what had came about, I called him up and I prayed for him the prayer of ordination. And I gave him some instructions. You're stepping now from the evangelistic field into the pastoral mode. And these are certain things you must know and understand and how to conduct yourself now. And he has obeyed. Is very proud of knowing him as a friend. Most individuals, when you have the opportunity to lead, have a tendency to do their own thing. And my advice to him was, don't change nothing. And he has continued to preach the gospel just like Elder Ron Hawkins would have desired to have it preached, and have conducted himself in a pastoral mode of taking care of the flock. That's the spirit of love. So on the back of your program, it says it is an amazing at how God arranges things to be, regardless of what the devil's intent is. Isn't that something? God arranges things long before things come into existence, so that when they happen, he already has something in place. As I was talking with Sister Hawkins this morning, this came about by default. By default. My phone rang one morning and it's Elder Jones. Elder Peter? I said, no, this is not Elder Peter. I said, well, I dialed Elder Peter. I said, who is this? I said, well, this is Elder Howard. He said, Elder Howard. I said, yes, this is Elder Howard. I'm from the Williamsburg Church. He never had my number. I never gave him my number. But yet, in dialing, it came through the line. God rearranged it and sent it straight into my phone. And that started the relationship. We were on one accord. Amen. I invited him down, went to his pastor and said, it is all right if he comes down, because you must do things indecently in order. Elder said, you never accept a man from another church in your pulpit without the combination of the man who oversees it. All things must be done decently and in order. So it is amazing at how God arranges things to be, regardless of what the devil's intent is. Now, for those who have paved the way for us, built us upon this sure foundation, having Jesus Christ as our head, who promised that the very gates of hell would not prevail against it, speaking of the church of God, established by the man and the woman of God, and have been passed on to us that we might carry it on. And watch this. Confirms his promise today by what? Our existence. We are still alive today. And Jesus promised us that the gates of hell would not be able to prevail against his church. Today, the church of God is still very much alive. Hereby shall all men know that you are my disciples if you want to have love one for the other. So truly, we thank God for existing today. And on the front of the program, it says the promises made are what? Being confirmed. May God bless you, church. Heaven ever smile upon you. Let us continue to hold on. Look up, but don't give up. It's good to see each and every one of you pressing your way out. Thank God for having Brother Tim in the midst today. Coming down with the choir from Calvert County. Amen. It's good to see you all. We went in. When I got to church that Friday night, they were singing that song, "This Is Not Our Home." What was that about? This world is not my home. Can you strike it? I want them to sing that for you.
Let's do it.
Amen. And after they finish singing, we're going to have Elder Jones to come to break the bread of life. Amen. Amen. All right, choir.
Yeah. God bless you, Pastor. Sing it anyway, sing it. Sing it anyway. Sing. Yeah. Stranger passing through.
Stranger passing through. This world is not my home. Yes, sir. Stranger passing through. You don't know. You don't know what I've been through. Had to go. Had to go. What I had to do. I've been down. I've been down. Till my last breath. Yes, sir. But it's good.
It's not my home. Yeah. Stranger passing through. Oh, this world is not my home.
I'm just,
oh,
a stranger.
I'm just a stranger. Stranger passing through. Oh, you don't know.
You don't know.
You don't know what I've been through. As a soldier.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Ain't he worthy? Ain't he worthy? God is worthy. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the shade, he said that the name of the Lord should be praised. Amen. He's not forcing you into a praise, but he said everything that had breath, he said let him praise the Lord. He ain't trying to make you praise him, but he said if you just have a little breath, just praise him, because he's worthy. This world, precious one, is not our home. We just a stranger. We just passing through. And sometimes we get down to our last dime. Amen. Don't know what we're going to do. But his blood will lift us up. Jesus is a lifter upper. Amen. Not a bringer down. If you've been brought down this morning, you're on the wrong drug.
Y'all ever been on drugs? I've been on drugs. And you get the wrong drugs. Some is upper, some are downer. And I had it all. But the downer will bring you down. And that's what the devil do. He's a drug that bring you down. But when you get the high on Jesus, he will lift you up. He will lift you up. He will give you a praise on beyond this whole place here. It'll have you filled with joy and gladness of heart. So we thank God this morning that this world is not our home. We recognize, amen, that through the promise of God, and God confirming his promises through generation to generation, that he said, Jesus said, I'm going away to prepare a place for you. And if I go away to prepare a place, I'm going to come again. That's a promise. Then he promised us a new Jerusalem. Amen. A holy city who built it and Mecca is God. That's a promise. And he said, repent, every one of you, and be baptized for the remission of sin, and you shall receive the power of the Holy Ghost. And that's a promise. And I got that promise. Woo! Ain't it good to have that promise? So I know that there's a heaven that we go into because of the promise of the indwelling power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. So we thank God that this world is not our home. Amen. If you stuck on staying here, you got a big problem. You need to be born again. Amen. You need to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Repent of your sins and get Christ in your life. Because once you get born again, your mind, your spirit changed. You made up that this world is not your home. You're from a new kingdom. Who built it and maker is God. But if you're operating under the influence of yourself or the devil, then you from another government. You're under another government. And that government is the devil, the prince of this world. This world is not our home. Amen. So the little pain and the heartaches, we got to go through all that temporary. It's just temporary. Because this world ain't our home. We ain't going to have that all the time. We going to a place there will be no more sickness, sorrow, pain, or death. For the former things have fled away. And he said, behold, I'm going to make all things new. I don't know about y'all, but I'm happy this morning. Amen. I ain't happy because I got money in my pocket. And I ain't all that happy because I got my health and strength. I ain't happy, amen, because my wife's sitting over there in the corner. But I'm happy because I got Jesus. Amen, because he has saved me from sin and gave me a new life to begin. Because things can make you happy, but it don't last. But you got to have an eternal joy. You got to have a joy unspeakable, full of glory. And that comes from God alone. Amen. Because you know how we do. We get a new bicycle. That'll make us happy for a while. Amen. You get a new car, but then after a while, you have a flat tire. You were happy when you got the car. Amen. But weeks later down the road, when you got to put new tires on it, amen, you ain't so happy because you don't really altogether have the money. But when you got Jesus, amen. You got eternal joy. Amen. You can be all right with God. So I'm happy this morning to be found in the house of God, to pill in the ground on the truth. Ain't God good? God is worthy. Amen. To be praised. Amen. Yes, he is. So we thank God for just being God all by himself and beside him there's none else. Thank you for his son, Christ Jesus, who suffered, bled, and died on a cruel cross of Calvary for the sins of all mankind. And we thank God for the precious Holy Spirit that God gives to them that obey him. Thank God for his word. God's word is a lamp unto our feet and is a light unto our path. It's a shield and is a buckler to all them that put their trust in him. And we have learned how to trust God. Amen. Through the thick and through the thin, through the ups and the downs, we can put our trust in the Almighty God. So truly God is good and he's worthy to be praised. Thank God for the men of God that labored down through the years, Ella Lightfoot Miss Shaw back in 1919. Amen. Ella Raymond C. Wills. Amen. 1937, 39. Amen. And we thank God for the late Bishop Hawkins. Amen. Amen. We thank God for the men of God that labored down through the years, that we can sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Then we thank God and honor God for the men of God today. Amen. Pastor Howard. Amen. Williamsburg Church. Amen. Of God. Amen. God bless you. God bless you real good. Amen. We thank God for the dear Pastor Ronald Hawkins. Amen. Church of God of Lothian. I mean, Calvert County. Amen. We thank God for Ella Derek Hawkins, Church of God of Lothian. Thank God. Amen. For all the men of God that's laboring down through the years. Amen. And all those that's laboring today, standing on the Word of God, teaching us how to get out of sin and how to stay out of sin and how we must be born again. It's one thing to repent, get out of sin, but then you must stay out of sin. You must stay up out of it. Amen. And only the divine instruction from the Word of God through the power of the Holy Ghost, amen, can give us that. Amen. So we thank and praise God for all things. Thank God for such a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful weekend that we have had. Amen. 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 Give honor to Pastor and his dear wife. God bless you, Sister Smith. God bless you real good. Amen. We thank God. We know he couldn't do it all by himself. One thing about a man of God, he always got a great woman of God behind him, pushing him. Amen. Not trying to lead him, not trying to direct him, not trying to force him, but help pushing him. Amen. Give him a little nugget on the back every now and then. Honey, you're doing a good job. Amen. Sometimes we need to hear that. We don't need to hear this and that, but we need to hear, honey, you're doing well. Honey, you're preaching good. Wonderful message. Amen. But we hear all the negative stuff all the time. Amen. Wasn't for God, you won't sit down. But the Holy Ghost just keep you going. So we thank and praise God from women of God. Amen. To stand behind the men of God. Amen. And I say that because, you know, he brought the bus up to pick us up, didn't charge us a dime. Not one dime. Ain't that something? Hey, we're all here today because didn't charge us a dime for that big old pretty bus out there. That smooth riding bus. Amen. And we thank God for him. Amen. Because she could have been a hindrance. Although he was going to do it anyway, because he operated under God. See, men of God got to do what God tell them to do in spite of. But I thank God, I want to give her flowers too that she deserved. Amen. So we thank and praise God for her. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Then not only that, but God spoke in the word that you will have children and they will speak with the enemy in the gates. And we thank God for the wonderful, amen, family that he had. Amen. All the son and the daughter. God bless you. We thank God for each and every one of you. Every one of you. But we thank God for Brother Matthew. Amen. Coming on up. Bringing us all back, giving us the tour of Jamestown, the museum and all that. Ain't God good taking his time out? He got wife and family, but he took his time out. And we honor his dear wife that stand behind him. Amen. Allowing him to be so gracefully and treat us with the love, amen, that God has shed. Ain't God good? That's love. That's love. Then they come down, they took us all about, and amen, amen, amen. Now I know you switched up drivers on us, and Brother Deacon Keith. Amen, we thank God for him. Amen, took over the rest of the day and the night. Amen. Thank God for him, how God used him to be a blessing to us. God bless you, Deacon. Amen, beautiful song this morning, amen, as he picked us up this morning for Sunday school. Church started on the Sunday school bus this morning. Ain't that something? Sunday school bus. For all those that didn't know, there was a Sunday school bus. And we had a good time in Sunday school. So I give honor to each and every one of you, all the wives, of the husband, the daughter. God bless you. Amen. We thank God for her. God bless your daughter. Amen. We thank God for her. We thank God for each and every one of you pressing your way down. Amen. To Williamsburg, Virginia, all the precious saints from Calvert County. We give God honor for you. Amen. Pressing your way down. Amen. Amen. Brother Kentish, God bless you. My dear friend, Brother Kentish. Thank God for him to shock me this morning, surprise me. Amen. Not too much of a shock because he usually always be here, but he surprised me this morning because we haven't been together for a while. You know, so I didn't call and tell him anything about it, but I thank God for him and his dear wife. Brother Charles, God bless you, Brother Mitchell. Amen. My dear friend in the gospel, brother in the gospel. Seen him a week or so ago. He said, I'll be there. Seen him at the McDonald's. He was coming out. He said, I'll be there. Yeah, amen. So thank God for him and his dear wife. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Sister Hawkins, God bless you. Thank God for Sister Hawkins pressing her way. Amen. And my dear daughter already lived down here, but she's my daughter in the gospel too. I thank God for her. Give her a big hand. Thank God. Bless your daughter. Amen. We thank God for each and every one of you. My dear son. Amen. Thank God for him, his dear wife and family. Amen. Pressing their way down. Amen. Always good to have strong foundation, firm foundation. You have somebody sticking by your side. Amen. So I thank God for him. Amen. Wonderful sons I have indeed. Amen. But this one sticks real close for some reason. I don't know why. Amen. The other one chose to go another route. But this one stuck to choose to take this route with the camp. The other one went opposite the camp. Something don't add up. Amen. But we thank God nevertheless. Give honor to my dear mother. Amen. My aunt Bird. Thank God for them. Amen. 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 And last but not least, I thank God for my queen that God has blessed me with. Amen. Truly, truly indeed. Thank God for her being by my side through thick and through thin. Amen. God is truly good. I often say I was strung out on crack cocaine and all the drugs, you name them. I can give you a whole list of them, but you name them, man. I've been there and I've done it all. Amen. I end up on the road, walking the road, stinking and dirty, end up in prison back in 1990. And I remember crying out unto God. And he said, this poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and delivered him out of all his trouble. And I cried unto God. I said, Lord, I know I'm going to do my time, but I just didn't want to come back home the same Quentin that I was leaving. And I was sick and tired of being sick and tired. Anybody ever been there? Been sick and tired of being sick and tired? Sometimes we get sick and tired, but that just ain't enough. But when you get sick and tired of being sick and tired, amen, then you know you really need some help. And the help ain't in man, but the help is in Almighty God. So we thank God for that and how my prison term and all. And God allowed my wife to stick by my side every step of the way. Amen. So truly I thank God for that. And God, amen, shortened my time and brought me back home and called me into the ministry. And I ran for years. Didn't want nothing to do with this ministry at all. Didn't want nothing to do. I was just a happy being the usher and on the choir. I'm still happy. Singing with the choir. Amen. Amen. I even got mad at God because I thought he forced me into this thing. Amen. I was mad with him for years. I said, Lord, I didn't want to do this, but you forced me into this thing. But I found out one day, I think it was about 4 years ago, it really clicked in. I've been in the ministry almost 20 years, but 4 years ago, that's when it really clicked in, that it was love. It was love. The love part settled down in me for the gospel. Amen. For delivering souls from sin. And that's when it really clicked in. And now I just accept it and run full force with it. So I thank God for it. I don't have no problem where I got to go, what I got to do. I'm going to stand on the word of God. Amen. So I thank God. Amen. I ain't mad with God no longer. I had to go down on my knees and say, Lord, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, Lord. Please forgive me. Because I was mad with him. But I ran for, he called me in 93 and I didn't accept the call to 95. And after I accepted, I still didn't accept the responsibility of the ministry. And that's one thing, but ministry, even with the wives, they got to accept the responsibility of the ministry. It's all about the souls of people. And that's what true divine love is. Sacrificing yourself, putting ourselves on the back burner, amen, for everybody else, that somebody can be saved. So that's what Jesus did. Amen. So we thank God for, amen, just being here. Amen. Truly wonderful. Then I got to the motel, gave the woman my money for the room, and the woman gave me my money back, says, all paid for. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. All paid for. Didn't even come down looking for that. Okay. Woman just pat me. She said, pat me the money back. She said, you took care. I said, huh? Yeah. She said, all right, give it here. Give it here. Ain't God good? God told us on Friday night that he was gonna bless our house, didn't he? Didn't he tell us he's gonna bless our house? He was going to increase us more and more. And he's been increasing us ever since Friday. He's been increasing our wisdom, our knowledge, our understanding, our pocketbooks. He's just been increasing everything. Amen. So we thank God for the increase. It's good to serve the Lord. If you don't know God in the pardon of your sins, get to know him. It's good to know the Lord. I'm telling you. So we thank God for all things. Not going to be before you long. The Lord gave me a little theme. I'm going to ask you, amen, digging if you will. Amen. Amen. A little theme. We turn your Bibles to Exodus. Amen. Truly, this has been a blessed weekend. Been a blessed weekend. Hate to leave. I told Pastor Howard, one of these days I'm going to walk, come down here and walk around one of these houses down here 7 times. I know what God do when I walk around something. I know it's over. I know it's a done deal. Amen. I'm going to walk around here 7 times. Amen. I like this country down here. But God is good.
Glad to have you.
Amen. Exodus, if you will. Amen. Deacon, if you read the
chapter,
the 11th chapter, in the 4th verse.
And Moses said, thus saith the Lord.
Thus saith the Lord.
About midnight.
At midnight.
Will I go out to the midst of Egypt?
What?
And all the firstborn in the land.
And
of
all
Egypt,
the firstborn of the land shall die.
From the firstborn of Pharaoh. That sitteth upon his throne. Even unto the firstborn of the maidservants. That is behind the mill. And all the firstborn of the beast.
And what?
There shall be a great cry throughout all the land of Egypt.
And we'll stop right there. And we'll take a theme from there. The midnight cry.
All right.
He said there's going to be a great cry at midnight. Ain't that something?
Yeah.
Precious ones, we are in the land of the living. And I know in this land, as we journey through this walk of life, we're going to go through some things.
That's right.
We're going to go through some trials and some tribulations and some persecution, some distress, some aches and some pains. Amen. And you're going to go through a whole lot.
Amen.
As we journey through this walk of life. And it looks like, amen, that there's no hope. Mm-hmm. But the Spirit of Christ just want to speak to us this morning. Just tell us. They're going to be a cry at midnight. Your darkest hour. Mm,
that's right.
Going to be your gloomiest hour.
Yeah.
Amen. Your darkest hour, when trouble on every side look like it's hitting you, that's going to be your gloomiest hour. That's going to be the time that light going to spring forth for you.
Yeah.
The midnight cry.
That's right.
I know sometimes we shed some tears and we go through this so much, and our family members care us through so much, and church folks care you through so much, and you know, and you cry for your family member, this one, and you want this one saved, you want that one saved, and you know, so much going on, and all the problems that you have to face every day. It's like a midnight to you.
Yeah.
It looks like your darkest hour, where there's no hope of the sun to shine. But one day, Jesus is going to shine.
There he is.
One day he's going to shine on your situation.
Yeah.
All you just got to do is hold out just a little while longer.
Yes.
Just hold on till God's unchanging hand. Turn to the second chapter, if you will. Mm-hmm. Let's read. Amen. Read that fifth verse. And he said,
and the daughter of Pharaoh came
in the fourth
verse.
Uh-huh.
And when the Lord saw that he turned aside.
And the Lord
saw that he
saw that he had turned aside, talking about Moses. He told Moses, and Moses said, I'm going up into the mountain. He said, I'm going to see this great sight while this bush is burning. In other words, God got his attention. Sometime through our midnight cry, midnight hour, God's got to get our attention. That's what it's all about. He's trying to get your attention.
That's
sometime
right.
We journey through this life and we in sin so long.
Preach it.
Sin got you bound. Drugs, alcohol, fornication, adultery, lying and stealing. You bound so long.
Yeah.
In the darkness of sin. And sometimes God got to allow something to get your attention.
That's right.
In this day and time, amen, God's allowed the bush to start burning. To get the attention of Moses. Why? Because he heard a cry for years, almost 400 years before he heard a cry. Mm. Ain't that something?
Yeah.
Read what it said, Diggy.
God called unto him.
God called unto Moses.
Out of the midst of,
the midst of the bush.
And said, Moses.
And said, Moses.
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 And he said.
And he said.
Here am I.
Hallelujah. It's good when God called you, you say, here I am.
Yes.
Here am I.
That's right.
Don't sit up in the church all your life and God speak to you service after service and you have a deaf ear to it. But one of these services, you got to say, here I am. Here am I, Lord.
That's it. Here am I.
You know, we lack the singing and we lack the shouting. We even lack the tap.
Here am I.
But when you say, God say, Moses, Moses, or Quentin, Quentin, or you, whatever your name may be, we supposed to at least have enough sense to say, here am I. What you got to say to me, Jesus? And when he speak to us, just have a mind to do it.
That's it.
He said what?
And he said.
And he said.
Draw not nigh hither.
Draw not nigh hither.
Put off thy
shoes
from off thy feet.
From off thy feet for what?
For the place where
thou standest
is holy ground.
Is holy ground. Precious one, when you come into the house of God, this is holy ground.
Yeah.
It's a place where God honor dwells. We don't want to take it lightly. Amen. When we come in before the presence of God. Amen. We ain't coming any kind of way. Amen. But we coming to hear from God. this morning. Amen. This is holy ground. Amen. Read what it says. So we don't take God's house lightly. Well, what did he say, Diggins?
Moreover, he said, I am the God of thy father.
I am the God of thy father.
The God of Abraham.
I'm the God of Abraham.
The God of Isaac.
I'm the God of Isaac.
And the God of Jacob.
And I am the God of Jacob.
And Moses hid his face. For he was afraid.
For he was afraid to look upon God. What?
And the Lord said.
Read all that to get to this.
I have surely seen the afflictions of my people. Which are in Egypt.
Precious one, the same God that was the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It's the same God that was of Moses, Joshua, and Aaron. The same God of Ella Lightfoot, Mishaw, and Ella Wills, and Bishop Hawkins. It's the same God today. He said, I have seen the afflictions of my people.
In other words,
I'm looking down from heaven.
Yes.
And I see what my people going through. I see your enemies that's coming up against you. Amen. I see them trying to bind you and hold yokes and put yokes on your neck. He said, I see the affliction of your people. You're in the darkest hour now of your trial of life as you journey. And you wonder how you can get over to the other side. But we're going to the other side, whether you know it or not. Yeah. Jesus said that. Yeah. He said, come on the ship. We're going to the other side.
Amen.
But it's all right now.
Yeah.
We're in a dark hour. Look like a dark and gloomy day. These tests and trials are so great. Amen. But God is letting the people of God know. Amen. No matter what you're going through this morning. Amen. He sees your afflictions.
Amen.
He sees who's bothering you that shouldn't be bothering you.
Preach
he sees where every ache and pain come from the devil's camp. He sees who's trying to curse your finances, that your blessings won't flow when they need to flow. God said, I see your affliction. I see everyone that's trying to fight against you.
Amen. Preach it.
Pharaoh had him in bondage for years, making bricks without straw. For years, oh yes he did, have been a hard taskmaster. That's what the enemy of our soul is. He's a hard taskmaster. As we going through this, that's why we say, the Bible says, sing the song, we just a stranger passing through. Don't set up stakes down here. I don't want to be under the taskmaster of the devil. I don't want him to keep whipping on me. I'm heading to a better place.
That's right.
Place called heaven.
Yeah.
Amen. Ain't no taskmasters up there. God said, I've seen the affliction.
That's right.
Your people. He said, he heard your cry at midnight. The midnight cry. He heard you. Your darkest hour that you're going through right now. He heard your cry, precious one.
Amen.
And he gonna come down and deliver you. Show us we born to die. He's going to come down. That's a promise that he gave us. He's going to come down to deliver us.
Amen.
He said, I have seen the affliction of the people. What?
Which are in Egypt.
Which are in Egypt.
And have heard their cry.
And I have heard their cry.
By reason of their
taskmaster. By reason of their taskmaster. And what?
For I know their sorrows.
For I know your sorrows, God said. He know what you're sorrowing about. He knows
Amen.
All about it, mother. Daughter, sister, amen, husband. He knows your sorrow.
Amen.
He knows what you got to face from day to day. He knows the attacks of the enemy and how he brings them on your job, in the school, even in your home. He knows the attack, the affliction that the enemy is putting on you.
Yeah.
And he heard your cry.
Amen. Thank you.
Anybody got to cry sometime?
That's
that
right.
Midnight cry.
That's it.
That's a long cry, ain't it? Whole lot of stuff happened when you cry at midnight, man. Snot run out your nose. Oh my God, man, it's something. You're pouring all your heart out. But God see it, and God hear it, and He said, "I'm gonna come down to deliver you." Read what it say.
And I am come down to deliver
and
you.
And I have come down to deliver you. Turn back to where we left. What? 11th chapter. Mm-hmm. Amen. Let's read it. Read that fourth verse.
And Moses said,
thus said the Lord,
About midnight, will I go out?
About your darkest hour, he said, I'm going to go out.
To the midst of
Egypt. I'm coming out. In other words, he seen it. God sent Moses down through the process of time. Amen. After God took Moses, amen, took him and led him over to the wilderness. Amen. And he took care of Jethro's sheep for a while. Amen. God was saving him up there. Getting them ready to go down to lead a people that was so great. Amen. God had greatness on them. While they was, making bricks without straw. God had greatness on the people of God. He got greatness on you right now. Even though you're going through your trial and tribulation, there's some greatness of God on you. Right. And God see everything that's going on. Amen. Yeah. And God said, told Moses, he said, I'm going to send you down. He said, and Moses told him, he said, I can't speak. I can't go. I don't know what to say. Amen. God said, you just go. I'm going to give you what to say.
That's it.
He took Moses up in the wilderness. Amen. Moses was up there 40 days and 40 nights. Amen. He had to go through the process. Amen. Of getting ready to lead a people. Everybody can't lead.
That's right.
Amen. That's the problem with church folks today and how churches, our members getting messed up because you got leaders that can't lead.
That's right.
That's the whole problem with the church. Everybody want to lead,
but
everybody can't lead because they're not a leader.
That's
you got to be ordained by God.
That's right.
It's one thing for man to set you up. Amen. But we talking about when God sets you up.
That's right. Amen.
Been down through the Bible. You go down through the Bible, all these false kings and all that was set up because the people wanted them.
Yeah.
I say, you want a king? I give you a king. He going to rule over you.
That's right.
He'll make you slaves. Back slave back to your evil characters, your evil sins, your evil attitudes.
Mm. Isn't that something?
Yeah, you want a king?
They got it.
I give you one. Let you serve yourself.
Right.
You'll serve yourself instead of serving God. You wonder why all of a sudden the evil attitudes and all that stuff started coming back because you're serving yourself. Mm. We got to get out of ourselves.
That's right.
Amen. That was Moses. God was teaching Moses. Come up in the mountain and fast and pray and get out of yourself.
That's right.
I'm going to do this through you.
Amen.
Can't be in self.
That's right. Preach it.
He took Moses and he led him through there. And Moses, on the way, he met Jeff, the sheep of, amen, of Jethro. And he ended up taking care of them sheep for a while, a little small group of sheep. Nothing wrong with having a little group of sheep. Ain't that wonderful? God put you over a little, you know, we don't do it. God do it. Put you over a little group of sheep for a while. He said, you be faithful over a few. I'll make you rule over many. And that's how it works with God. First, you got to be faithful where the least where he called you at.
That's right.
You can't come church at the least. How he going to put you over top of much? If you ain't come when the least was going on, you ain't learned proper protocol or nothing how it's supposed to operate through the will of God.
That's right.
All of a sudden, you want to jump over. Amen. It don't work like that. Amen. But God said he see your afflictions. He see what you're going through.
Amen.
He heard your cry.
Yes.
And he said he going to come down to deliver you. And Moses said at midnight, we know the story. Amen. God told Moses, go down. And he went down and went to Pharaoh. Amen. Told Pharaoh, let the people go. And Pharaoh would not let them go. Ain't that something? Mm. The devil just want to keep a hold on you.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
But the Holy Ghost is speaking this morning. Let the people go.
That's it.
Got to let them go.
Yes. Thank you.
Man always want to hold. He won't hold you. He won't tug you. Well, he won't tug you. But the Holy Ghost said, you got to let them go so they can serve me, Jesus
said.
God want them to serve the Lord. Don't let nothing hold you back from serving God. Our truth.
That's right.
You fool around and let oil get in water, you're going to have a bad engine. Mm. You let water get in oil, you're going to have a bad engine. That car ain't going to run for so long. You fool around, let some bad stuff get up into the holiness. Amen. It ain't going to operate right, Lord.
Preach it. Thank you.
Man, it goes a little while, this and that, put. But sooner or later, that engine going to stop. Them valves going to stop pumping up. Amen. The ring going to stop turning. Amen. The camshaft going to stop spinning. Amen. Before you know it, it's going to throw a rod. Amen. Clunk up. Amen.
Right.
And then it's good for nothing. It's all over there. Mm. Amen. You need a rollback. You need somebody to tow you.
That's right.
To another play. Read what it said, President D.
And all the firstborn in the land.
And all the firstborn of the land shall die. Or Egypt shall die. Everybody, the Bible said that all souls are mine.
Right.
But the soul that sinneth, it's going to die.
That's right.
You got to keep sin out of your life.
Amen.
The soul that sinneth, all soul belong to God.
That's right.
But every soul that sinneth, every soul that disobeyed God is going to be eternal separated from God one day. And this is why God giving you a chance now to get right with God. He see the affliction of the people. He see that sin got you hope, got a hold on you.
Yes.
You're trying to get off the drugs. You're trying to get off the alcohol. You're trying to stop lying. You're trying to stop fornicating and adultery, but you just can't stop.
Preach it. Thank God.
Sin got you bound. And God say, I see the affliction.
Yes.
And he said he wants to deliver you.
Thank you.
And that's what he sent the Spirit of Christ in the world today to deliver you out of the condition of sin.
That's right.
God's people saved from sin.
Right.
Not in sin, but saved from sin. You got to be delivered from sin.
Preach it.
Russell said ungodly attitudes. Amen. Hypocrisy and all that stuff. He had a whole list of. You got to be delivered from it.
Amen.
I said, I'm seeing the affliction of your people. You're afflicted with that. And I see it. And I want to deliver you, he said. The midnight cry.
Yes.
And there was a cry. Read what it said, D.
From the firstborn of Pharaoh.
From the firstborn of Pharaoh.
That sitteth upon his throne.
That sit upon his throne.
Even unto the firstborn of the maidservant.
Read it.
That is behind the mill.
That behind the what?
And all the firstborn.
And all the firstborn of Egypt. And what?
And there shall be a great cry.
And there shall be a great cry.
Throughout
Saints of God, it's going to come a day that there's going to be a great cry. And if you're in the house of God this morning, amen, and you're not under the influence of the Holy Ghost, there's going to be a great cry one day.
That's right.
And you need to be born again. You need the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
You must have God's Spirit.
Preach it.
Amen. You can't leave this world without it. Amen. This world is not our home.
That's it.
But if you don't have the Holy Ghost, it is your home. Amen.
Yeah.
You need the Holy Ghost to take up root from here and go to the other place, go to heaven. You must be born again.
Amen.
You must be endowed with power from on high. You must be born again.
Preach it.
Church of today is limited the Holy Ghost. They're afraid of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Churches got them afraid because they all falling out and all this stuff, got all this crazy stuff going on. People afraid to commission God for the Holy Ghost. But God said, you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost come upon you. He'll give you some power to live this life in this journey of life without sin in your life.
Amen. So true.
You need the power. Read what it said then.
And there shall be a great cry.
There shall be a great cry throughout all the land.
Such as? There was none like it, nor shall be like it.
It's going to happen again. There's going to be a great cry.
Amen.
And throughout the land, it's going to happen again.
Yeah.
This land, amen, is in mourning. Church folks are in mourning.
Yeah.
Amen. That's why the land in mourning, because the church folks mourning.
Mm-hmm.
And this land, man, is full. The Bible says it's full of adultery. Ain't that something? It's full of fornicators. Yes, it is. It's full of murderers. And now they got men, man, and woman, man, woman. Amen. They're killing on every street corner now, Baltimore. Amen, man. And it's just crazy. D.C., they just ride up to him and just shoot him on the motorcycle. Boom. Just shoot the daughter. Ain't that terrible? The Bible says, blessed is the nation who God is their Lord. If this nation get rid of God, this nation ain't going to be blessed too much more longer. And we looking at a nation now that's forgetting God.
That's right.
They're forgetting all about God. They're from the president on down.
That's right.
They're forgetting all about them. They talk about it, but they're forgetting about it. About God's ways. And the worst part of it is, it's church folks that is forgetting about their creator. Church folks are forgetting about the one that saved them from their sins.
That's right.
Church folks. But they're going to be a cry at midnight. It's going to be a midnight cry.
Amen.
And we must be ready.
That's right.
When that time comes. You must be ready.
Yeah.
When that cry comes. It's going to come.
Amen.
A day. Amen. Your darkest hour, that gloomy, dark night. Amen. It's going to be a cry. It's going to be for the people of God.
Yes.
To go back to be with the Lord.
Wonderful.
I believe Paul and Silas, take over there to Acts real quick.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Matter of fact, read that 12th verse, Deacon. 12 and 12. Exodus, real quick. For I will pass through the land.
Mm-hmm. For I will pass through the land of Egypt.
For I will pass through the land of Egypt this night.
And will smite all the firstborn.
Smite all the firstborn in the land of Egypt.
Both man and
both
beast.
Both man and beast.
And against all the gods of Egypt.
All the little gods, all the gods of Egypt.
I will execute judgment.
Why?
I am the Lord, God said.
And what?
And the blood shall be to you for a
token.
And
the blood shall be to you. Talking about putting the blood on your doorpost. Back there, they had to sacrifice putting the lamb's blood on the doorpost.
Yeah.
Amen. Of the house. So that the death angel will pass you by. Amen. But now, you got to have the blood of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
On your doorpost.
Yes.
The doorpost of your heart.
That's right.
You got to have the blood of Jesus Christ on you. Amen. When that cry come through the land, you better have the blood of Jesus Christ on your doorpost.
That's right.
If you don't, that death angel, the spiritual death angel, ain't going to pass you by. You're going to spend eternity in a burning hell where you're going to be separated from God for eternity. Ain't that something?
That's right.
Read what it said, Deacon.
And the blood shall be to you for a token.
And the blood shall be to you
for a token.
For a token.
Upon the houses.
Where ye are.
And when I see the blood. I will pass.
That's another message within itself. When I see the blood. Ain't that something?
That's right.
Amen. When God looked down from heaven, he want to see the shed blood of his son.
That's right.
Upon your life.
That's right.
Amen. When you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior and repent of your sin, amen. Guess what? You're under the blood there.
That's right. Covered.
You're under the token of the blood of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
When God looked down from heaven, that's what he sees. But the world today is in gross turmoil. When God looked down and he don't see the shed blood of his son upon the world today. The son is in a dying state.
Yes.
This world is in a dying state, precious one. Don't get caught up in this world and this worldly goods and this worldly ways and nothing about this world. Don't get caught up in it.
Amen.
Read Acts, if you will, digging over there, Acts the 16th chapter. Amen. Paul and Silas had a midnight experience. The 25th verse, I believe it was. Amen. At midnight.
Paul and Silas prayed. And sang praises.
See, God said, I heard your cry. I see your affliction. I know your trouble. I know what you're going through. Son, daughter, mother, father, God knows what you're going through. Church, God knows what you're going through.
Amen. Thank you.
He knows what the enemy trying to plot. What they deceiving, what they putting up on. He knows.
He knows.
Said there's going to be a midnight cry. And those that did it ain't under the blood. Your enemies that come up against you, they ain't under the blood. Under the blood, you don't act like that.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. Not blood-washed people. Act like Jesus act. Yeah. Read what it say.
At midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God.
And what happened?
And the prisoners heard it. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake. So that the foundations of
that
the
foundation, man, I'm gonna tell you, when God moves, hallelujah, you can just cry out unto God sometime. Just stop and talk to Him. And I'm telling you, God will come by and He'll rescue you.
That's right.
But you gotta cry out sometime. Paul Silas was in prison. I remember them days back when I was in prison, man. I cried unto God. Amen. And there was a great earthquake. Back in that time, and Paul and Silas, that ain't God good.
Amen.
God will shake up some stuff, brother, brother Maker. Amen. Yes. He will shake the foundation of your enemies.
Yes.
Of your soul. He will shake the bank account. He will shake, amen, diabetes, yes, high blood pressure,
amen,
and back aches and leg aches. And He will shake it up.
Preach on.
He shake up husbands. He'll shake up wives. Amen. They give you problem when you're serving God. Amen. He'll shake them up.
Shake them up. Bet He will.
He said there's going to be a great earthquake. He's going to come through for you.
Yes.
Earthquake, separate, divide, man, destroy, and get rid of some stuff.
That's right.
Yes, it does. All you got to do, hold on. Just hold on to Jesus. Hold on, Pastor Howard. Just a little while longer. God said, gave us a message to the church and preached to the church. God said He's going to shake heaven and earth. And since that Lord gave me that, gave us that message, He's been shaking it. Amen. Tornadoes and hurricanes coming through the plane and dropping out the air. Amen. He's been shaking heaven and earth. Because He's trying to get some attention.
That's right.
Trying to get some out of attention. God's going to get your attention, whether you like it or not.
That's right.
Yes, He is. He know how to burn a bush right in your sight. And won't let the bush consume. Mm. Ain't that something?
Power of God.
And suddenly there was an earthquake so that the foundation of the prison was shaken.
And immediately, when
God come through for you.
Right. Immediately.
Immediately.
All the doors were open.
All the doors that were shut for you. Gonna be open. Anybody got the shut door right now?
All right.
Huh?
Yes.
The midnight cry.
That's it.
That midnight cry gonna open some doors for you.
Thank you.
Yes, it will.
Thank you.
Sometimes you just gotta steal away.
Yeah.
Steal away home. Ain't got long to stay.
Yeah.
Steal away. Steal away. Steal away. Home, steal away to Jesus.
That's right.
I ain't got long to stay. Steal away. My Lord calling. Hit me by thunder. Trumpet sound within my soul. I long to stay. We ain't got long, precious one.
Amen.
God, hear our cry. We don't have long to steal away and talk to Him. Steal away home, talk to Jesus. Get your mind up to heaven and talk to the Lord about it. He said, the doors were open and everyone's bands was loose. Anybody shackled down? Anybody got some hooks on them right now? Amen. Jesus is going to come to your rescue.
That's right.
Amen. He's going to loosen some stuff for you.
That's right.
I prophesied to you this morning under the authority of the Holy Ghost that whatever was bound in your life, amen, that wasn't supposed to be bound, going to be loose.
Thank you. Amen.
God getting ready to loosen.
That's right.
Whatever doors that were shut, that was hindering you.
Thank you.
God's going to open them this morning.
Thank you.
He's going to open up some doors for you.
Amen.
And no man can shut them. Y'all believe that?
Amen.
Believe it, God, this. He's going to open up some doors for you. He might have to shake some stuff up, but it's all right. If you got to do an earthquake, Lord, for my family to be saved, shake the earth. That's right. Amen. Whatever it takes, just save my family.
Yes.
Just save my in-laws.
Save my
loved ones. Lord, just save in the progress. And God would do that.
Yes, he will.
Amen. He gonna open up some door. Read what it said, Diggy.
And the keeper of the prison.
And the keeper of the prisoner said what?
Awaking out of his sleep.
Waking out of sleep.
Seeing the prison doors open.
Seeing the prisoner.
He drew out his sword.
He drew out his sword and what he said?
Himself.
And want to kill himself.
Supposing that the prisoners.
God said they come against
fled.
You one way. Amen. But they'll flee from you seven ways.
Right.
Ain't that something your enemies?
Mm-hmm.
Those that try to keep you bound. They'll come against you one way, but God said they're going to flee seven ways.
Mm.
See the affliction of your people. Y'all seen the story? You heard the story?
Yeah.
Amen. The children of Israel, where they were faced by the Red Sea.
Mm.
And then Pharaoh behind them. But God, he opened up a door for them.
Mm.
The door of the Red Sea. He opened it up and carried them through on dry land, didn't he?
Yes.
Yes, it did.
Make a way out.
Amen. Then he swallowed them up by the sea. Your enemy. That you won't see their faces no more. And God would do the same for you and I. The enemy that come up against you. God said you'll see their face no more when he get through with them.
That's right.
Amen. Read what it said, Diggy.
But Paul cried with a loud voice.
But Paul cried with a loud voice.
Saying, Do thyself no harm. For we are all here.
For we are all here. That's why it's good to be in the place where God's presence is. Ain't that something? Don't do no harm to nobody.
That's it.
Don't harm nobody, precious one. Through all that you got to go through, your trial, your tribulation on your job, don't harm nobody.
Don't say
nothing to harm nobody. Watch the words that come out your mouth.
That's right. Thank you.
You harm people with your words.
That's right.
I said, when I was a child, I spoke as a child. I act like a child. But then when the love kicked in,
that's it.
I became a man.
Thank you.
And I put away child of things. You got grown up. Now you got to be careful how you talk to people.
Right.
Amen.
Preach it.
I said, you see the affliction of the ones you talking to like that.
Thank you.
Can't talk to us any kind of way. Can't talk to me any kind of way. I'm not going to tell you now. Can't talk to me any kind of way. I'm a child of the Most High God.
Thank you.
I've been anointed by the God of heaven. I was ordained from the belly of the womb. You can't talk to me any kind of way.
That's right.
You sure can't talk about me and get by with it. Careful how you talk to me. I'm careful how I talk to you.
That's it.
God's children. We all God's children.
That's right.
We don't talk to them any kind of way. God said he see the affliction. He said it's better to put a millstone around your neck and jump over to the depths of the sea to offend the least of my little ones.
That's right.
And I'm so glad I'm a little one. I'm so glad I'm one of his little ones. Man, God, what scripture say? Fill your mouth with gravel. You know that proverb, I believe. Otherwise, you it take you to your grave. Well, you fill your mouth with gravel.
Hmm.
Cloud calls you out while you woofing. After a while, your mouth shut right up. You can't say another word. You'll die. Your breath gone.
That's right. Preach it.
How we got over there? That's just a bonus, I guess. That's just a little bonus. God give us bonuses every now and
then.
That's right. We journey through this walk of life. I guess that's a little bonus. All good, Pastor. But he sees the affliction of his people. What he's saying is that I see my people and what they're going through. And those that's harming my people,
that's right.
I'm going to fight the battle.
Yes.
I'm going to deliver them.
Thank you.
I'm going to come to their rescue.
Amen.
And God would do just that.
Yes, he will.
And we finish that, Diggy.
Then he called for a light.
Then he called for a light.
And came trembling.
And sprang in and came trembling
down. Fell
down
before Paul and Silas.
Paul and Silas, what did he say?
And brought them out.
and said, Sirs, what must I do to be saved?
See what I'm saying? Deliverance, precious ones. The midnight cry can bring deliverance, not only for you, but for your loved ones.
Right.
Y'all see the affliction of your people.
What must I do?
Coming down to deliver them. Sometimes you cry for the husband. Sometimes you cry for the wife. Sometimes you cry for the children. Sometimes you cry for aches and pain. Amen. Sometimes you cry because you just don't have a penny. Amen. But God, He sees all.
That's right.
He knows all.
Yeah, He does. Thank God He does.
The light spring. At midnight, the light spring. The light of the gospel, the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ that will spring up. Yes, it will.
Yes, glad about it.
Men, women, boys, and girls can be saved when the gospel of Jesus Christ is lifted up. And that's what He wants us to do. Lift up the Christ to a dying world. Men, women, boys, and girls, precious ones, need to know that there is a Savior.
That's right.
And His name is Jesus. And He can save us from sin.
Amen.
He is a deliverer. Moses delivered back then. Amen. But now Jesus is our deliverer.
Yes.
He's got to deliver us. And He can do it.
Yes,
from any condition that you're in, He can deliver you.
Amen.
Read what it said, D.
And they said, believe on the Lord.
Believe on the Lord Jesus.
Christ. And thou shalt be saved. And thy house.
And thy house. Ain't that something? God just added to a Friday night message, didn't He? He said, 115 songs. He said, I'm going to bless the house of Israel. I'm going to bless the house of Aaron. I'm going to bless the house of Quentin Jones, Senior.
All right.
He might bless the house of Junior wasn't there. He might miss the blessing. He might get it. He going to get it because you know why he said he going to get it? He said, and our children.
That's it.
And our children. So y'all can get something too. Ain't that something?
Yes.
He'll bless the house. He said He'll increase you more and more. 115 song. Read that song one of these days. That'll bless your heart.
That's it. Thank you.
Y'all got to believe it. The gospel of the light shine into your soul. You start believing the gospel of Jesus Christ. You start walking in it. Amen. Your life will be blessed.
Amen.
I'm telling you, it will be blessed. God took me from a dope head on walking the road, stinking dirty, and now I got my own business. God, somebody. Never would have thought it.
Amen.
Talk about what God can do. He can do that.
Yes.
He said He'll make you the head and not the tail, above and not beneath. He'll bless everything you set your hand and do, tread your feet upon. Why? Because He sees the afflictions of your people.
Yeah.
He's coming down to deliver you.
Thank you.
He said, Sir, what must I do to be saved? And they said, Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Thou shalt be saved.
Amen.
And thy house. And what He said?
And they spoke unto him the word of the Lord. And to all that were in his house.
And all that was in the house. And what?
And he took them the same hour of the night.
And washed their stripes.
And was baptized.
He and all his straightway. Ain't that something? Everybody that was in the house that got in contact with Jesus, believe on the Lord Jesus,
amen,
got delivered.
Yes.
Saints of God, there's going to be a midnight cry. When they turn over there, 25th chapter of St. Matthew, and let's go home. Amen. It's been a beautiful, beautiful weekend.
Yes.
It's been so beautiful. I hate to, you know how sometimes you hate to see something in? Y'all, anybody ever been seeing a carnival come in town and set up Back in the day, they came in and set the carnival up, and it might last a week back then. Now, only last like 3 days. But back then, it lasts whole 7 days, week, a whole week. Mm-hmm. And sometimes we couldn't afford to go, but we would ride by, see everybody out there and playing and carrying on. Then we go home. The next day, we ride by again. And hoping that we going one day that week. And then end of the week come, you ride by and you see them putting the stuff in the truck, packing up, and your heart drop. You hate to see that thing in, you know, especially if you have been there a couple nights and had a good time. I don't know how them people was at last night at the Bush Garden. They hate to see it in. Well, look, can you call? And I said, God, y'all know you're supposed to be meeting this such and such place. Well, can you call this one and tell that one to pick us up later? And y'all go ahead and catch the bus and call my dad. Tell him come get.
Woo! 8 o'clock.
Told him 8 o'clock. We trickling on out there, what, 8:30 or so?
Well,
they said, man, them roller coasters.
Real.
Boy, them roller coasters, boy, something. I missed it. I wanted to at least get on one, but I missed it. I ain't mad, though. I'll catch it next year. Cause I wanted to do that 2015 roller coaster. I'm gonna do it one of these days, Lord be willing.
All right.
Yeah, I got conquered this little thing, little bug, spiritual bug that's troubling me. I got conquered. Sometimes God got to use situation to conquer. So
that's right.
I ain't gonna let that thing control me.
That's it.
Control it. Midnight. Midnight cry. You might see me hanging off
there. There it is.
That roller coaster coming on down. Woo. You heard somebody crying and screaming, you can say, that's Ella Jones. Might be on there by myself. Give me a ride by myself. 25th chapter. Amen. Read what it's saying. We're closing now.
What verse?
25:1.
25:1.
Uh-huh.
Then shall the kingdom of heaven
shall
be like
the kingdom of heaven
unto 10 virgins.
Unto be like unto 10 virgins.
Which took their lamps.
Which took their lamps.
And went forth to meet the bride.
And they went forth to meet the bride.
Five of them were wise.
This is the problem with the church world today. You got virgins in the church. In other words, you got people in the church that accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. The 10 represent, you got five that's wise and you got five foolish. And sometimes that's half and half. Sometimes half of the church is wise and half of it's foolish. Ain't that something?
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we ourselves are half wise and half foolish.
Tell it.
We haven't got rid of all the foolishness.
Preach it.
But 99 and a half ain't going to do with God. It's got to be 100% with God.
Right.
And this is the problem, amen, with the church world today. Church is all on every corner, look like. But you got some wise and you got some that's foolish. Don't just let anything go on in the church.
Yeah.
Just come any kind of way and do anything you want to do. Not with God.
No, no.
God make us a wise and an understanding people.
That's right.
Amen. We got to live with wisdom. So he said it was virgins. Mm-hmm. And they took their lamps and went abroad, and five of them was wise, and five were foolish. And what?
They that were foolish took their lamps.
They that were foolish took their lamps.
And took no oil with them.
And took no oil. In other words, you got the vessel. You got the vessel.
There it is.
And the vessel can operate in the way that it should operate, but it got to have something in it to operate that way.
Thank you. Yeah.
Got a vessel in your house, a lamp in your house. Amen. The storm come. Amen. Thunderstorm, lightning. dark in there, dark as eye, midnight, dark as eye. And you go to the, amen, the closet, and you get your lamp. Amen. Then you go and get your vessel, mm-hmm. your old vessel. And you find out that ain't no oil in it. Mm. Ain't you going to be upset with yourself? Mm. Man, I've been to the Walmart quite a few times this week or months or whatever and never got the oil. Now you got a lamp without oil and you're walking in darkness and you're stumbling all over top of stuff. Fall, hit your head and die. Amen, because you don't have no light in the house. Mm-hmm. Foolish.
That's right.
That was foolish.
That's right.
Ain't that something?
Yeah.
Foolish.
That's right.
When somebody, and then a lot of times people, you know, husband or the wife tell a husband, the white husband tell a wife, you know, you got to get some oil. But you don't take the instructions.
That's it.
That you're supposed to take to do what you have to do.
Right.
This is why Jesus gave us the instructions.
That's right.
To get the oil in our lamps.
Yes.
It's necessary. There's no use walking around, amen, and don't have nothing in you.
That's right.
Because why? Amen. What is in you gonna show up?
Gonna show up.
So it's just a matter of time. I don't care what's in you,
it's coming out.
It's gonna come out you.
Amen.
You got a nasty attitude or you just foolish or whatever, it's gonna come out. God, what he do, create a situation. Mm-hmm. It'll come out.
Right there.
I told him. 8 o'clock. Stupid self. It's foolish.
Yes.
Love kicked patience in.
Thank God for patience.
I called Deacon Keeb. He told me he'd be there. He said he'd be there in 20 minutes. He was dead. Now, but he ain't called me. Where you at, Elder Jones? His Holy Ghost just set him still.
Amen.
Waiting, patient.
Got some work done while I was waiting.
Yeah. But we, as the church, is growing more ignorant in our last days on this earth as the body of Christ. But God said, I see your affliction.
Yes.
And I got to deliver you.
That's right.
But in order for me to deliver you, I got to let you see what state you in.
That's right.
I got to create a situation so that you can see the state that you in.
Preach it.
You know how we walk along like we got it going on. Ain't nothing in me. But sooner or later.
It's coming up.
And you must be like Jesus. Jesus said, the prince of this world coming, but ain't nothing in me. That's how it's supposed to be. But when test time come, God going to show us the trials and prove us to show us what's in us.
Yes.
The mean people on our jobs, it's to show us what's in us.
Yeah.
It's not them. We know what's in them. They're not saved. Yeah. But yeah. God do it to show what's in us.
All right. Preach it.
Yeah.
Preach it. Thank you.
Around your house, he showed what's in us.
Yeah. Coming out.
It's going to come out. Five foolish, five wise. The foolish took their all, took their lamps, and took no all. But the wise, what?
But the wise took all.
Took all in their vessels
with
their lamps, and what?
While the bridegroom tarried,
they all slumbered and slept. But what happened?
At midnight. There was a cry made.
At midnight, pressing one. I know right now we journey through this walk of life, and it looked like Jesus ain't coming. Has been preaching over 2,000 years that the Lord is coming. And while the bridegroom, the lady is coming, we slumming and we sleeping now. We not waking up and filling those vessels with the oil that need to be in there. But our vessels, we need to be wise and understanding people. Now, our vessels need to be full.
Preach it.
The Bible says that the unclean spirit goes out of man, and when it go out, it seeks a place where he can get in. In other words, he try to find another body to get in.
That's right.
And when he don't find none, he said he come back to his house.
That's right.
Why do he claim you as his house? Mm. Mm.
Preach it.
He says swept up.
Cleaned up.
It's garnished. It's nice and clean. In other words, you got the proper attire. Hey, man. Hair covered. Got all that going on. You know how to sing.
Yeah.
You got all that.
And empty.
But it's empty. He said he found the house empty. Talking about the spiritual house. Mm-hmm. We come, we sing and shout, we preach and pray, but we're not filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
You must, amen, have this vessel filled with oil. The oil represent the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
You know, man, oil shines. Yes. And you take oil, put it on your head, it shines, don't it?
That's right.
Represent the light of the gospel. The Holy Ghost shines throughout the world.
Amen.
The dark and gloomy night.
Yes.
At midnight.
There was a cry made.
There was a cry made. What did it say?
Behold.
Behold.
Bridegroom cometh.
The bridegroom cometh.
Go ye out to
the bridegroom cometh. The bridegroom cometh. That was the cry. The bridegroom cometh.
Go ye out to meet him.
A bridegroom only come back after one thing.
That's it.
That's the bride.
That's right. Amen.
Somebody ought to know who the bride is. We living in this world. Somebody should know who the bride is.
Amen.
In your job, on your home, in the church, they should know who the bride is. In the theme park. Wherever you go, they should know who the bride is.
All right. Yeah.
This thing is real. That's see, right. You just can't keep coming. You got to receive this thing in your spirit. You know, when most people, some people don't like the word of God. They just blow it off. I'll be glad when time go home. And that's why you can't grow. Because you always worry about time go home. And you can't grow in the gospel because you're not receiving the gospel. All you receive what the enemy is putting in your mind. It's time to go.
Yeah.
But if you take time out and say, I don't care how long the Holy Ghost take to deliver, get this nasty thing out of me. And he got a yank on that tooth. Hey, amen. How the dentist do. They got a yank, yank, yank for that wisdom tooth. Hey, amen. Don't care how long it take, Holy Ghost.
All right.
You'll circle to... And don't land till you get me out of here. Don't land till you get me out of here.
All right.
Get that nasty attitude out. Amen. Get the lying and the stealing, the whoremongering and the adultery. Get it out.
Get it out.
Amen. At midnight, there was a cry made. The bridegroom cometh. What?
Go ye out to meet him.
Go ye out to meet him. And what he say?
Then all those virgins arose.
And all those virgins arose.
Trimmed their lamps.
See, there's going to be a day that we all going to be gathered. Amen. Some going to be cast into eternal life and some to eternal damnation. Because some was foolish enough to stay in this world without getting oil, without getting filled. Without getting delivered, amen, from this world and condition of sin. He said, the foolish said, what?
Unto the wise.
Unto the wise.
Give us
ain't
of
that
your
something?
Own.
How do you wait till the last minute and then you want something somebody else had? Amen. But you got to get this thing for yourself. I only got enough Holy Ghost for me. Amen. Amen. It's got to be Christ in you, the hope of glory. You got to get it for yourself.
That's it.
I can't give it to you. I can tell you how you can get it. Amen. Amen. But I can't give it to you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Give
Amen.
Us.
Read what it said, D.
Give us of your oil.
Give us of your oil.
For our lamps are gone
For our
out.
Lamps are gone out.
But the wise
but
answer said.
The wise answer said, not so.
Not so.
I ain't doing it. Amen. Because you must be full of the Holy Ghost. If I give you some, amen, I ain't full no more.
That's
hey,
it.
Even if I give you half of it, then I'm only half full. If I give you a quarter of it, then I'm three quarters full. But you got to be full of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
That's
when
right.
the Lord Jesus comes and
right.
crack the sky, you got to be full of God's Spirit.
You're right.
Amen. Read what it said, Dick.
Lest there be not enough for
Lest
us.
Lest there be not enough for us.
And you.
And you. And what?
But go ye
but
rather
go
to them
ye
that
rather
sell.
To them that sell.
And buy for yourself.
Amen. You to use this worldly goods all your life. Go back to the world, amen, and get it.
Yeah.
Go back to the world and get your all.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Buy, get it from those that buy and sell. But what?
And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came.
And while they went to buy, see, they were foolish. They was foolish. You know you can't buy this thing.
That's right.
The Holy Ghost come down from heaven, you can't buy. Well, the wise say, you go and buy, go get it from them that buy and sell. And they went to the store, the market. Can't look for the Holy Ghost in the market.
That's it.
Up on the shelves, the Walmarts, the Giants, and the Safeways.
Mm-mm.
You got to look for it, amen, in Jesus.
That's it.
Read what it say, Diggy.
While they went to buy.
And while they went to buy.
The bridegroom came.
The bridegroom came.
And they that were ready.
And they that were ready.
Went in with him.
Went in with him.
To the marriage.
To the marriage.
And the door was shut.
And the door was shut. Gonna be a midnight cry.
That's right.
And it could be this morning.
Yeah.
The Lord could come this morning.
That's right.
Amen. Right while we're sitting here. He could come.
That's right.
Nothing stopping him from coming. But only the call from God. It's the only thing stopping him. If God the Father would say, go down and get the bride, he would have to go down and get it.
That's right.
He had to do what the Father tell him to do.
That's right.
That's the only thing stopping Jesus right now from coming back after the body of Christ. So if you're not, amen, having repented of your sin, you're not saved. It behooves you to get saved from your sins.
That's right.
Amen. Get your vessel filled with oil so that you be ready, amen, for this wonderful marriage that's going to take place.
Yes.
And it's going to be a beautiful marriage that's going to take place. And they shut the door, and afterwards what happened?
Came also the other virgins.
Afterwards the other virgins came, saying what?
Lord, Lord, open to us.
Lord, open unto us.
But he answered and said,
Verily I say unto you,
I know you not.
I know you not. Ain't that going to be some sad words?
That's right.
Lord, Lord, you've been good to me. When I look where you have borne me, show me. But he ain't going to say that in that day. I don't care how much we sing that to him. That day, Lord, you've been good to me. Lord, you did this for me. You saved me from here. You done that. He going to say, brother, I say unto you,
I know you not.
Watch therefore.
For ye know neither the day nor the hour.
When the Son of Man cometh. Exodus tells us, amen.
Midnight.
That they're going to be a great cry. Like never was before. Paul was telling us about the midnight cry. 25th of Matthew was telling us about the cry of midnight for the bridegroom.
Yeah.
Amen. Was coming. He's coming back after the church without spot or wrinkle or any such thing. Don't play with your souls, precious ones.
That's right.
Your soul is the most precious thing you have.
Thank you.
Don't let the enemy talk to you now and tell you, amen, you got a little bit more time. You can play with the world, or you can do a little bit this, and you can do a little bit of that. You got to cut off them old friends.
That's right.
You got to cut them completely off.
That's it.
Amen. Their old ways, you got to cut them completely off. The evil communication, you're going to corrupt good manners. God's word don't lie. You got to cut them off. You got new friend now. Your new friend is Jesus Christ. That's the best friend you need is Jesus. There's not a friend like the Lord Jesus. No, not one. No, not one.
No, not one.
Say it to you this morning. Amen. I encourage you. If you don't know the Lord, amen, in the pardon of your sins, get to know the Lord. Maybe while the choir sing a song of invitation, maybe somebody want to get to know Jesus. Of a truth. We know you might have heard about him, but we're talking about get to know him. We're talking about get to know him. We know preachers talk about him all the time, and you people heard about him all the time. But we're talking about get to know him personally for yourself as your Lord and Savior. He will save you this morning. He will deliver you out of any condition of sin this morning and give you a brand new life to begin. Come to Jesus. Come to him. It'll make you free. If you come to it, yeah. When there's no hope, he'll give you hope. Where the sadness? He'll give you joy.
He'll give you joy. He will pick you up.
He'll turn you around.
He'll turn you around. Place your feet on.
He'll place it on solid ground. Come to Jesus.
Oh, come to Jesus. Right now.
Amen.
Come
to him. He'll set you free.
He'll set you free.
If you come to him,
he'll set you free. Wherever.
He'll give you hope.
He'll give you
hope. Where the sadness.
Where the sadness.
Oh, he'll give you
joy. He will pick you up.
He'll turn you around.
He'll turn you around. Place your feet on.
Amen.
On solid ground, come to Jesus, come to Jesus, right now.
Amen. We truly thank God.
Right now.
Yes, you ought to come on. You ought to come on. We'll turn it over to the pastor. It's fine, church. God bless you. God bless you, Pastor.
God good. Midnight. Amen.
God's going to turn things loose for you. So we're going to turn the service now over to the Diggins to sing a song and take up collections. Amen. All right, Diggins.